Hi, I'm Dr. Jerry Jackson, out with the wild things. One of the annoyances of a walk in the woods in late summer and fall is the occasional encounter with spider webs that cross our path or are blowing in the wind. These are generally the work of orb-weaving spiders, those spiders that create a somewhat circular web that is used to capture their insect prey, a web that to many is just a typical spider web. The web of orb-weaving spiders is a complex structure composed of silk lines laid down in a spiral pattern that creates a flat oval. It is composed of two kinds of silk, each produced by a different gland. Some strands are sticky and some are not. The spider walks on the ones that are not sticky and depends on the sticky ones for his next meal. The reason that we more often walk into these webs in late summer and fall is that earlier in the year, spiders and their webs are much smaller. As they grow, spiders need more food and their webs are larger and often placed higher in vegetation, often right at our eye level. With the warp-weaving spiders, those that make a large oval web with which to capture their prey, are resident on every continent except Antarctica. And some likely reach there, but don't survive. The family that includes orb weavers includes about 2,700 described species, and many more likely remain undescribed for science. The greatest diversity of orb weavers is found in the tropics, but about 200 species are known from North America. One reason that these spiders are so widespread is their unique mode of movement. After hatching, a young orb weaver climbs to the top of a plant, hangs on with its head facing down and its abdomen up in the air, and begins spinning silk into the wind. The silk lines tend to form a triangle, and the wind exerts greater and greater force, eventually pulling the spiderling from its perch, and it sails off into the air at the end of the silk thread and kite-like structure it has produced. The process is called ballooning, but is more akin to flying a kite. Ballooning young spiders are at the mercy of the winds and can be carried for hundreds of miles before returning to Earth. Many do not survive. Some become pioneers in a new environment. All spiders have silk glands in their abdomen, and some have multiple glands and the capability of producing different kinds of silk for different purposes. Many spiders merely use silk as a wrapping to immobilize prey. They also wrap their eggs in silk parcels. Spider silk is a protein produced as a liquid, and the spider squeezes it out, much like you might squeeze toothpaste from a tube. As liquid silk comes out, it hardens as the spider manipulates it with the structures at the tip of its abdomen called spinnerets. The oval shape and spiral of sticky silk of an orb-weaving spider's web are obvious, but vary among species, and there are other elements to web design. A close look often reveals zigzag lines or a small patch of dense silk strands in the center of the web. The resident spider typically perches over this centerpiece. The structure is called a stabilimentum because when first described, it was believed to add stability to a web. Now additional functions are suggested, including camouflage for the spider, attraction of a mate, and deterring birds from flying through the web. One of the largest of Florida's web-spinning spiders is the golden silk orb weaver. The female's body can be an inch long, and her legs can extend her size to more than 3 inches. As their name implies, they build a web, and that web is made of yellow silk. The abdomen of these spiders is also yellow, and black and yellow stripes ring each leg. The female's abdomen is large and long, giving rise to another name by which she is sometimes known, banana spider. Golden silk orb weavers are found across the southeast and are especially common in swamps and wooded areas of South Florida, where they are most often seen in late summer with webs that can be 3 feet in diameter. Golden silk orb weavers are also around earlier in the year, but are smaller, and their smaller webs are lower and thus less noticeable. These spiders normally hang upside down in the center of their web as they wait for an insect to be caught. Male golden silk orb weavers are much smaller and duller colored than females, and are often found near a female's web or even clinging to the underside of her large yellow abdomen. One of the most distinctive of Florida's orb-weaving spiders is the spiny orb-weaver, so named because of the 6 large, black-tipped, red, thorn-like spines that extend from around the edge of the female's body. The female is often strikingly shiny white above and mostly black below. She encloses her eggs in a silken sac and attaches the sac to the underside of a leaf near her web. Male spiny orb weavers are smaller than females, gray above instead of white, and lack the conspicuous spines. They just hang around, literally. They tend to hang from a line of silk suspended from the web of a female, perhaps taking advantage of small insects captured in her web, and certainly waiting for the opportune moment to mate. Spiny orb weaver spiders are found in the tropics and into the southern United States from Southern California to Florida and north to Virginia. Spiny orb weavers are harmless to humans and a real gem to discover. With the Wild Things is produced at the Whitaker Center and the College of Arts and Sciences at Florida Gulf Coast University. For the Wild Things, I'm Dr. Jerry Jackson.